What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I appreciate you stopping by, spending a few minutes of your time here with me today. Today, instead of going over with you charts and trades and trade setups and things like this, I want to talk to you a little bit about trade management, all right? How to, when to, why to exit a trade, all right? Personally, I have some guidelines. I have a little bit of a process that I follow that enables me to take profits safely and consistently, all right? Which is very important for me, all right? Now, I just began my journey with prop firms, all right? I'm in the middle of a challenge evaluation account for a funded account, right? And I'm doing this really just to get my toes wet, to learn what it's all about, because I did a couple weekends worth of research, but it was kind of hard for me to understand what all of these different rules mean when it comes to the prop firm. So I figured the only way I'm going to understand it is if I just go for it and do it, all right? And so far, it's been going very well. A lot of people online complain about prop firms, and specifically complain about prop firms having too many rules that are too strict, right? As if they're trying to set you up for failure. A lot of people talk like that. But as I get more familiar with the rules, I actually manage my personal live account in a very similar way, all right? Including certain drawdown limits. You know, every day or every week, there's a certain limit that if I hit that in drawdown, I'm going to be out of the market, at least for the day, right? I also have a limit on the profits that I take, right? I'm not aiming for the fences, trying to hit a home run with every single trade. I have a certain amount of money, a certain percentage of the account that once I hit that, I'm pretty comfortable with just taking that and getting out of the market. You understand? And this is very important. This is how prop firms run. Essentially, the prop firm wants you to showcase your skills and also your discipline and self-control. And you prove that by gaining small, consistent gains, right? If you can maintain that, you get paid. Now, I have some very simple guidelines that help me do this, okay? And we'll go through them really quick. And then I want to try to put this in perspective for you from a psychological standpoint, right? Or a practical standpoint. We want to talk about the logic and the reasoning behind this sort of thing, okay? So, like a lot of people out there, I use key levels as my targets. So if I am taking a 3-session setup, for example, and I'm going to be taking this from the high of the day to the low of the day, I may have the previous day's low as a target, all right? And so when the trade reaches that level or gets near to that level, I will be thinking about shutting this trade down, regardless of how much money I've made, you know, the profits that I'm at. This is the target. I'm considering shutting this trade down, all right? Another common thing that I use and many other traders use is candlestick formations and patterns, okay? So if we have made it to a key level or we're near a key level and I see evidence of the momentum exhausting or weakening, okay, or the market potentially shifting and reversing in the other direction, I will shut the trade down, all right? If I'm entering on an M pattern at the high of the day, if I see a W thrown at the low of the day, I will shut that trade down, no questions asked. So I'm using key levels. I'm also using candlestick patterns, all right? Now, those are common things. Now, the next two I'm going to share with you are more like unique to me. They're personal to me. And I know that other people do this, but this is what really sets it apart for me, okay? So, not only am I using key levels and candlestick patterns, I'm also using timing, okay? If I'm taking a 3-session setup, for example, I know that this trade is probably going to be over within 5 to 15 minutes, okay? If I'm taking a 3-day setup and I'm trading from high of the week to the low of the week, I might be in this trade for anywhere from 15 minutes to 45 minutes, maybe even an hour in certain cases, okay? And that's it. So if I enter a trade, for example, at 9:32, I am going to check it again at 9:40, 9:45, and see what's going on, all right? And if at that time we are near a key level, we're getting a certain candlestick pattern or whatever, I'm considering shutting this trade down, all right? If we're not pushing lower after 15 minutes, I'm considering shutting this trade down because that's probably all I'm going to get. I'm just trading a 3-session setup, which is really a session scalp, okay? It's not one of the big 3-day setups. It's just a session scalp. So I know after about 15 minutes, I'm trying to get out of there, okay? My last 4 trading days, meaning the last 4 days that I took a trade, I was out of the market in 15 minutes, done with my day by 9:45, which my local time is really 8:45. So by 8:45 in the morning, I'm done. I've spent about 30 minutes at my charts total, doing my analysis, taking my trade, exiting the trade, and I'm done. Shut the screen down, go on about my day. Stress-free, that's how I like it, okay? So I use the timing. You know, I'm trying to time my trades with new candlestick formations or rotations, excuse me. So new 15-minute candle rotations, new hourly rotations. I'm entering the market and exiting the market around those times, okay? Now, the last guideline that I use to sort of help me gauge when to exit a trade is a certain percentage of my account balance, all right? And this is not a target. This is not a percentage or a dollar amount that I'm aiming to make every day. I don't really believe in that, okay? But what it is, it's a certain percentage that if I hit that percentage, I am going to shut the trade down, okay? I don't care if we've made it to a key level or not. I don't care if we haven't gotten a certain candlestick pattern, okay? And I don't care what time it is. If I hit a certain percentage of profit on my total account balance, I'm shutting the trade down, I'm shutting the computer down, and I'm going on about my business. This is very, very important. All right, especially if you're trading with a prop firm, because the prop firm has specific rules that sort of govern your drawdown and your potential profits, okay? There's something called a consistency rule, which basically states that no single trading day can exceed usually 30 or 40% of your total account balance. I mean, your total profit on the account, all right? So if you go over that, you won't fail the account, but you will up the profit target for a potential payout or to pass your evaluation. So you need to keep your trades consistent, all right? Your losses need to be consistent under a certain amount, and your profits need to be consistent, okay? That's very, very important. If you trade prop firms and you complain about the rules make it really hard for you, you're doing something wrong. Okay, you just don't have the right skill set, or you're thinking about it the wrong way. This is how I think about my live account. This is how I think you should be thinking about your money as well. Whether you're trading a demo account, you're trading your own live account with your own money, okay, or you're trading a prop firm, you need to imagine that this is not your money, okay? You need to imagine that you have secured an investor. Someone, perhaps they're someone close to you, like a close friend or a family member, right? Or maybe they're just a random investor, but either way, they trust you and they believe in you enough to fund your trading career. Maybe you've got a really nice mouthpiece. You talked them into giving you a large lump sum of money to trade with, and they expect a return on their initial investment, right? What are you gonna have to do to make them comfortable, okay? When it comes down to your trading, what are you gonna have to show them, right? If they wanna see verified statements at the end of every quarter, and you're gonna have to show that, what you've been doing with your portfolio, what is going to allow that investor to have peace of mind, to sleep well at night, knowing that they made the right decision to fund your trading business, okay? What are they going to want to see? Are they going to want to see, you know, very deep valleys and then very high peaks constantly, right? Are they going to want to see you taking a bunch of small losses and then securing one giant winner every now and then, okay? Or are they going to want to see you bringing in small, consistent profits on a regular basis, right? All they want to see is that account balance go up, okay? They do not want to see it go down. They do not want to see moments of weakness, right? Where you had a psychological breakdown and you took a big loss, okay? They do not want to see that. All they care about is that their portfolio is continuously increasing. They don't care by how much. They're not telling you that you have to make 50% every single year, okay? They'll be happy with 2% return on investment a year, okay? All they want to see, all they care about is that there are consistent gains going into that account, all right? And that's what you will have to show them in order for them to be comfortable enough to sleep well at night, knowing that they made the right choice. You understand what I'm saying? And that is what the prop firms want from you. That's what they force you to do. That's why a lot of traders fail that. It just so happens that I manage my own personal funds, my own live account in a very similar way. I am very risk adverse. I do not like to lose money. So I impose upon myself, out of my own volition, a strict system of entering and exiting the trades. You understand? So I use all of these things in combination to guide me to exiting my trades to take consistent profits. Because think about it, if you're trading a prop firm and you're in a challenge account, you only need to make a 10% profit target. So if every trading day when you trade your setup, you're able to lock in a consistent 2%, you're going to pass funded challenges without a problem, and you can do it quickly, okay? You can do it consistently, right? That's what's important, the consistency. As long as you have that consistency, the gains will follow. As long as you have that consistency and the mindset that's going to allow you that consistency, the payouts will follow. There's no choice, you understand? So you need to have a system, right? If you take a trade and it's a great trade, and now you're up 15% of your total account balance, a lot of people will think to themselves that they have a profit buffer now, and they will try to turn that 15% into 20. And a lot of the times, what will end up happening is you will end up shutting your computer down with a 5% gain or a 2% gain on the day because you got cocky, you got confident, you didn't know when to just take the money off the table and leave, right? So you end up trying to turn that 15 into 20 and you give most of it back and you end up kicking yourself in the ass for the rest of the day, wondering why you didn't take the money and run when you had the chance. You understand? That is a bad feeling. You know what the best feeling is that you're going to get out of your trading? The best feeling that you will get is when you have a plan, you have a process, you have strict rules that you apply to yourself and you follow those rules. You stick to the plan. You do not deviate, not even a little bit. And things go in your direction. The trade goes perfectly. You take the profits. You leave feeling amazing. That's the best feeling that you will ever have when it comes to trading. Okay? And you want to cultivate that sort of mindset of success, of taking profits when you see profits. Right? There's a lot of people out there, they're obsessed with letting winners run. They say, cut your losers early and let your winners run. A lot of people are confused about this. They think that that means every single trade, you've got to squeeze it to the max, let it run. You should get 100 pips every single time you're trading or something like that. But that is not how it works at all. If you are sizing into your trades appropriately according to your account balance, you should be nailing trades that give you the right sort of percentage gains in a timely manner. You should not be sitting in the market for 6 hours, especially if you're day trading, bro. You should not be sitting in the market for 3 hours hoping that something goes in your direction. When you trade, it should be something like this, right? When I got in this trade, I was done in 10 minutes. Everything shut down. I'm good for the day. You understand what I'm saying? That's how I like to trade, because I got it figured out. The lot size I need to use for the account balance, I know what I'm comfortable with making, right? I know not to get greedy. You understand? I have certain targets that I'm looking for, and I have these guidelines in place. You understand what I'm saying? It's very important. And I would just like to reiterate all of this stuff for you today. Remember, think about the money you're trading as if it is not yours, as if this is from a very important person who has chosen to invest in you. And what they want to see is safe, consistent gains on a regular basis. Okay? Anyway, man, until next time, I hope you continue to free your mind.